What comes to mind when you think of a scientist? Would you think, or maybe even?
My name is Paulette McRae-Barclift, and this is the face of a scientist.
I ain't that chick.
It's about self-empowerment. It's about self-awareness. It's about self-respect.
So I'm actually the first African-American, not just female, African-American, to receive a Ph.D. in neurobiology from Yale University. For a lot of us, Yale is so far out there. And for a lot of people, they will only, the closest they'll ever get to Yale is the sweatshirt with the right. Letters on it. But Yale is very familiar to you. It's home. A young kid from East Orange, New Jersey, that makes her way to Yale. How do you do that? It was a long path.
It was a very long path. A lot of work, a lot of hard work.
Take us to Yale. What was it like when you stepped on campus and, you know, when you started taking your classes and you saw that you were the only person that looked like you, right, and that looked like a lot of the young girls that are watching?
Yes.
What was that like? Were you intimidated?
So it was funny. The whole first year, and I'm going to be honest here, the whole first year, I was waiting for somebody to come and say, we made a mistake.
Really?
You were on the wrong list.
Why were you waiting for that?
And it's a very normal thing,
okay,
when you have put yourself completely outside of your comfort zone.
Okay.
Though I had, you know, I had the academics behind me. I'd done very well on the GRE, which was nothing short of God,
okay,
sitting there with me when I took the exam. That whole first year, you're just in doubt. And you're like, do
I belong? Normal.
Oh, totally normal. Absolutely normal.
You came from a regular family,
right,
with regular siblings, you know,
yes,
much like us, because I want them to be able to relate to you. So
right,
you worked hard.
I worked very hard.
But if you work hard, you can do it.
Absolutely.
You can
absolutely
do it.
And what happens is, as you start to work hard, you know your abilities.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, if I put this amount of time and effort into something, there's no reason that I can't achieve it.
Awesome.
And so when I was at the point where I was going to be applying to graduate schools, I had to really take a step back and say, what types of programs am I going to apply for? And I said, you know what? I've worked extremely hard and I believe in myself. And so, you know, I applied top of the line, and Yale actually was a reach,
yes,
for me, you know, and I said, what do
but
I have
you,
to lose? So
I love that.
You know,
you said Yale was a reach for me, but you reached.
You have to.
You reached.
You have to, because if you don't reach, you can't attain it. So
that's awesome.
Yeah, it was one of those where, you know, I was,
oh my
sitting
God, that's
with the
awesome
application, and I said, I'll never get in. But if you don't apply, you certainly can't get in.
And so now you're the only person in your class that's African American.
Yes.
In neurobiology, because not only is Paulette the first Black to get a PhD in neurobiology, she's also the first African American female. That's history. So this is somebody that you're going to see in your textbooks years from now. And I just think that, you know, when I was reading, I just said, I had to stop, and I think I clutched my chest and said, gosh, that is awesome. How does that feel to have a legacy like that?
You know, it's very humbling, and I'm a very humble person. And it wasn't something that, as soon as I started the program, I knew. It was something, actually, I was a couple of years into the program, because you're so focused. You're so focused on what you're trying to accomplish. And like I said, the first year, I was just trying to make sure nobody was going to come
right,
and tell me to leave.
Right.
So I wasn't concerned about that. I wasn't concerned about anybody else around me. And you know, I was there for a while, and it's very obvious when you're sitting in lectures, you're sitting in these large seminars, that there aren't many people in
mm-hmm
here that look
mm-hmm
like me. And that's okay, you get used to that. But there was a point when I said, you know, I wonder if there was, just because I don't see it now,
exactly,
does not mean there was not before
exactly
me. So I started to ask questions. I started to ask people that had been at the university for a while,
mm-hmm,
and the funny thing was the response, where they kind of sat back and they said, huh, you know, now that I think about it, I don't think so. I think you're the first one. And so that kind of piqued my interest.
Okay. Did that propel you to say, you know what, I'm onto something here? Like, did a light bulb moment go off?
Well, you know, I don't know if it was so much a light bulb moment as it was, let me get this answer. And that's what a scientist does, is I have a question, let me figure out
okay
the answer.
Good point. Good.
So, you know, I said, well, let me branch out. Let me go further into this. Let me really try to answer this. And so I went up to the dean and started asking questions. And they had to go back into their records. And
really? Yes, so you did that type of research?
Absolutely.
Now,
absolutely.
Did you do that with like a goal or purpose in mind? Were you going after, hey, I am going to be the first?
No, it was more, let me understand who's done this before me. And then it was, nobody has. Mm-hmm. And so at that point, it was like, wow. Because I just assumed, you know,
that
at
somebody
this point,
had, exactly.
We're well into 2000s.
And what year was this? This was...
So I finished in 2007.
But you would think by 2007, there would have been at least one.
Oh,
you would have thought they would have been two.
Right.
Maybe even three. Or heck, why not 100? But
exactly.
Wow.
Exactly. I know, it was totally eye-opening as I continued to probe people. Because really, as I started to ask different people the question and really climb up the chain, I was expecting someone to say, oh, you know what? There was this other individual, or here's a name. Here are a couple of people who have done it. And really, that was part of networking. It's let me figure out who's done this, who's walked this
exactly.
journey that I'm walking on. And to find out that you're actually the first one doing that is really is humbling.
But you know what's so beautiful about what you said is that you were looking for someone to connect with, to say who has walked this journey. But what's going to be nice is that some of our other little girls
yes.
can say, you know what, I know someone that's walked this journey, and they can actually put a face with a name. Looking back, if someone were to tell you, no, you couldn't do it, what would your response be to them?
My response would be, you're absolutely crazy, because I ain't that chick.
Now, if somebody was to look at one of the kids out there, or if one of the kids were to look at themselves and say, you know what, I can't, what would you say to them?
I would say, again, you have to believe it. You can't wait for somebody else to believe your dream for you. You have to realize your dream, and you have to go for it. You have nothing to lose.
Thank you so much for giving us an image, a new picture of what a scientist looks like. And let me just say, she's beautiful. Thank you for letting us see ourselves in you. Thank you for opening our imaginations. Thank you so much. I mean this, I'm in awe, because you are history. You are the first African-American, first Black, but the first African-American and the first African-American female to graduate Yale University. Wow. I got high five. All right.